नमस्ते टू ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री क्लास सिक्स विच इज़ व्हाट वेयर हाउ एंड व्हेन. थ्रू दिस चैप्टर एज द नेम सजेस्ट्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द इंसिडेंट्स अबाउट व्हाट वर द इंसिडेंट्स दैट हैपन्ड इन द पास्ट. वेयर डिड दीज इंसिडेंट्स हैपन. व्हाट वर द प्लेसेस. How did these incidents happen and when, which means what at what time did these incidents occur. So through this chapter we will be able to learn about the life of people in the past, about the importance of dates, about the historic and the prehistoric period and the first places where people started living. So starting with our chapter, Rashida's question. Rashida sat reading the newspaper. Suddenly, her eyes fell on a small headline, 100 years ago. How, she wondered, could anyone know what happened so many years ago? So Rashida, this girl was reading the newspaper and suddenly she saw a headline which said 100 years ago. So she wondered, how can anyone know about these incidents which happened so many years ago or 100 years ago. So let us find out. Finding out what happened yesterday. You could listen to the radio, watch television, read a newspaper. If when we want to find out about the incidents that happened yesterday, that happened the day before, we could either listen to the radio or we can watch the news on the television or we can read a newspaper. And if we find out, if we want to find out what happened the last year, so we ask somebody who remembers, we ask a person who remembers about those incidents. But what about long, long ago? What about, let's say, 100 or 1000 years ago or 500 years ago? So let us find out. See, our past is divided into two periods. One is the historic period and the other is the prehistoric period. The period for which we have written records, for which we have books and documents and manuscripts, that period is known as the historic period. But there was a time before writing was invented. So for that time period, we do not have any written records. So the period of time before the invention of writing, that is known as the prehistoric period. For that period, we do not have any written records. Now, what can we know about the past? What are the different things that we can know about the past? We can know what people ate, what were the different things, what were the different types of food that the people ate, what were the different kinds of clothes that they wore at that time, the types of houses in which they lived, and how were the lives of these people, how were the lives of hunters. Hunters were the people who hunted animals for their food. How were the lives of the herders? Means herders means those people who kept animals, who domesticated animals like cattle, goats, sheep, etc. How were the lives of the farmers, the rulers, the kings, the merchants? Merchants were the traders who bought and sold things. These people bought things from one place and went on to sell them at other places. How were the lives of the priests? Priests were the religious teacher who gave people advice regarding religious matters. And how were the lives of the craft persons and the artists, etc. Now, we can also know about the games that children played, the stories that they heard, the songs that they sang during that period. Moving on to where did people live? Where did people live in the historic times, in the past? Now, starting on with River Narmada. See, people lived along the banks of this river for several hundred thousand years. People lived along the banks of the River Narmada a long time back and they lived there for a long period of time. The earliest people who lived along the banks of the River Narmada, they were skilled gatherers. Skilled gatherers means these people, they collected their food, they gathered their food. They collected roots, fruits and other forest produce, other types of foods that were provided by the forests. These people, they also hunted animals. Now, as we can see in the map, The river Narmada is marked in the red circle. So the river Narmada, it covered small parts of Gujarat, parts of Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. Next, river Ganga and its tributary Son. See, the tributary of river Ganga is Son. So about 2500 years ago, cities developed on the banks of Ganga and its tributaries. As we can see, the first cities were established along the banks of river Narmada. Then around 4700 years ago, cities established around the banks of river Indus. And after that, around 2500 years ago, cities developed on the banks of river Ganga and its tributaries. Now the area along these rivers, the area along river Ganga and its tributaries, which is known as Magad, it became a very powerful kingdom. Magad is now a city lying in the state of Bihar. The rulers of Magad, they were very powerful and they set up a large kingdom. Now, as we can see in the map, as the Indus River Valley civilization declined, new civilizations were formed along the Ganges River. As we can see in the map, see, on the left, we have the River Indus. The River Indus flows in the west side. So, first people started living along the banks of the River Indus. But as the people, the population started declining, as the civilization started declining along the banks of river Indus, people moved and cities were established around the banks of the river Ganga. Now, name of the land. From where does our country get its names? See, two of the words we generally use for our country are India and Bharat. The word India, it comes from the Indus, called Sindhu in Sanskrit. The word India is derived from the river Indus. Indus means Sindhu in Sanskrit. Now the Iranians and the Greeks. Iranians are the people who come from Iran, and the people belonging to Greece are known as the Greeks. So the Iranians and the Greek, they came through the northwest about 2500 years ago to the Indian subcontinent, and they were familiar with the river Indus, and they called the river Indus, they called it as Hindos or the Indos. So in the our country was also known as the land to the east of the river. As we had seen in the map earlier, river Indus flows in the west and our country lies in the east of the river Indus. So hence our country was gradually named as India based on the river Indus. And the name Bharat, it was used for a group of people who lived in the northwest. A group of people who lived in the northwestern part of our country, they were known as Bharat, and these people are also mentioned in the Rig Veda. The Rig Veda, which is the earliest composition in Sanskrit, one of the four Vedas, it also mentions about these people. So later on, this name Bharat was used for our country. Now, how do we know about the past? How do we come to know about the past? There are different ways of finding information about the past. Everything and anything which gives us some kind of information about the past is called source. See, we have various ways of finding information about the past. So anything which gives us some kind of information is known as a source. So a source means from where we derive the information. Now, what do you mean by the term archaeology? See, archaeology is the study of the past by looking for the remains and objects left by the people who lived long ago. These remains could include old coins, tools, monuments, artifacts, etc. The study of the past, the study of the historical period, with the help of the remains and objects, the things which were left around by the people who lived a long time ago, the study of these objects, these remains is known as archaeology. And what were the remains? What according to us would be the remains left by the people? See, there are old coins, then there are tools, monuments, artifacts, various things like the weapons, or the pans and pots, the utensils which these people used. So all these things, the study of these things, the study of the remains and objects is known as archaeology. Now, who is an archaeologist? An archaeologist is a person. An archaeologist is a scientist who studies human history by digging up human remains and artifacts. An archaeologist is a person who studies archaeology. And as we read, archaeology is the study of human history. So an archaeologist is a person who studies human history by digging up human remains and artifacts. They try to find out the human remains. They try to find out the old objects. And then they study these objects to know about the historical period. As we can see in the pictures, we can see people who are trying to find out, who are trying to dig up the land and find various objects. Like we can see in the pictures, a skeleton has been found and the people are trying to find out various objects like tools and utensils, etc. So these things, all these remains, they help us to find out about the lives of those people, about how those people lived, about what type of food did they eat, or what were the tools or the utensils that they used. Now, objects that archaeologists may find. Now, what are the different objects that an archaeologist may find? See, there are different things that an archaeologist may find. There are bones, human skeletons or animal skeletons. Then there are coins, the coins which were used in the historical time, ornaments, jewelries that the people used to wear, pans and pots, means the utensils, the weapons that they used during wars, during fights, the tools which were used either to hunt animals or to make the pans and the pots, the remains of the buildings, the remains which are left from the old buildings, the buildings that those people lived in or that those people used. Then there are manuscripts and inscriptions. Manuscripts and inscriptions we are going to study in detail. And the plant remains, the various plant remains that were grown, or say the crops that were grown in the historical period. And then there are literary sources. Handwritten or any other written record of the past is known as a literary source. So literary source means the written records of the past or the historical period. So any source which is handwritten or written on any form which provides us information is known as a literary source. For example, the books, the manuscripts, the inscriptions, all these were the literary sources. Now, the literary sources, it includes two types of literature, religious and secular. Religious means the literature which gave information about the religions or which was related to a particular religion. And secular, the secular sources which were not at all related to religion. Now, manuscripts and inscriptions, we all have read just now that literary sources include manuscripts as well as inscriptions. Now, what is the difference between manuscripts and inscriptions? See, manuscripts, they were written by hand. This comes manu, the word manu comes from a Latin word manu, which means hand. So the manuscripts, they were written by hand and they were usually written on palm leaves or on barks of trees. So since there was no paper back then, so the manuscripts, these were either written on palm leaves, the leaves of the palm trees, or on barks of trees. For example, the bark of birch tree, which was used to write. And then there were inscriptions. See, the manuscripts were written by hand and were written usually on palm leaves, barks of trees, on cloths, etc. But the inscriptions, they were the engraved form of writing, which means the inscriptions, they were writings on hard surfaces such as stone, metal, etc. So these inscriptions, they were carved out, they were cut, the stone was cut and the information was then written on the stone or on the metal. If somebody asks you the year, or if somebody asks you the date, you will mention the date. You will say like the 18th of April 2020. So you'll mention the day and the month and you'll mention the year. Now the years, are counted from the date. Now, how are these years counted? The years are counted from the date generally assigned to the birth of Jesus Christ. How do we count the years? The years are counted from the year of birth of Jesus Christ, who is the founder of Christianity. So 2000 means 2000 years after the birth of Christ. The year 2000 would mean 2000 years after the birth of Jesus Christ. Now, all the dates before the birth of Christ, all the years before the birth of Jesus Christ, they are counted backwards and have the letters BC, means before Christ, added on before them. And sometimes we find AD added before or after dates. AD stands for Anno Domini, which means in the year of the Lord, which means after the birth of Jesus Christ. So the year 2020, the year in which we are living now, can also be written as AD 2020. Now, we can understand this with the help of this table given below. See, in the middle is the year 1, which is the birth of Jesus Christ. So as we study in maths, as we study on the number line, the center is the number 0, and the numbers coming before 0, the numbers to the left of 0 are taken as negative and are counted descendingly, and the numbers to the right of 0 are counted ascendingly, like 1, 2 and 3, and before 0 we go like minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. So likewise, when we are counting dates, year 1 or the base year is taken as the birth of Jesus. Now the time before the birth of Jesus Christ is taken as, is counted as BC. BC dates means dates or years before the birth of Christ. So 100 years before the birth of Jesus Christ will be taken as 100 BC. 300 years before the birth of Christ will be called as 300 BC. And 1000 years before the birth of Christ will be called as 1000 BC. But after the birth of Jesus Christ, for example, let's say 200 years, as we can see in the table, 200 years after the birth of Christ will be said to be 200 AD. And similarly, let's say 1000 years after the birth of Jesus Christ will be called as 1000 AD. And the year in which we are living now, 2020, this year will be, can be written as 2020 AD, means 2020 years after the birth of Christ. Okay, so this was our chapter, first chapter of history, and I hope you all have understood the chapter. Thank you very much. Historical period. Now, historical source, as we read, source is something which provides us information. Now, historical source is an original source that contains important historical information. Historical source is an original source and it gives us information about the historical period. These sources, they tell us or inform us about history at the most basic level. Now, the archaeologists and the historians, they study two main sources, which are archaeological sources and literary sources. First, archaeological sources. Now, what are archaeological sources? Archaeological sources are basically the material evidence like historical buildings, coins, inscriptions, and other remains. See, the archaeological sources, these are the material sources. For example, the monuments, the buildings that were built in that period that the people used, the coins and the weapons and tools that those people used. So all these are archaeological sources which the archaeologists can study, can find and tell to find out about the past, about the historical period. Travel. Now, people, they traveled from one part of the subcontinent to another. People traveled for various reasons. Now, what do we mean by subcontinent? A subcontinent is a large landmass which is a part of a continent only. For example, Asia. So the Indian subcontinent, it's a large landmass which contains which includes countries like India, Bangladesh, Pakistan. So this is a very large landmass, but not large enough to be called a continent. So these large landmasses which include several countries, they are known as the subcontinents. So people traveled from one part of the subcontinent to another parts. Now the hills, mountains, deserts and rivers, all these made journey possible. All these acted like natural barriers and made the journeys difficult. Now why did people move? People moved in search of livelihood. See, people moved in search of work, people moved in search of food or places to live in. They also moved to escape from natural disasters. Some of the times, there used to be natural disasters or natural calamities, like there were floods or droughts or earthquakes, etc. So to escape from, to save themselves from these natural disasters, people moved. Then the merchants. Merchants, we all have learned that merchants were the traders, these people. They bought things from one place and sold these things to other towns in other places. So the merchants, they traveled in caravans or ships carrying valuable goods. Caravans were vehicles, small vehicles, which were pulled around at that time either by oxes or horses, camels, etc. And these caravans, the merchants, they kept their valuable goods and they cooked food in these caravans and they used to sleep in these caravans. So the merchants, they traveled in caravans or they traveled in ships carrying their valuable goods around with them. Then the religious teachers. The religious teachers also walked from place to preach. The religious teachers, they walked from one place to another to give religious advice to people, to preach. Preach means to give people advice about religious just matters. Moving on to the Suleiman and the Kirthar Hills. Now, the Suleiman and the Kirthar Hills, as we can see in the map, these places are located in parts of Pakistan, Balochistan, and southwestern parts of Punjab. Now, the people first began to grow crops here, such as wheat and barley, around 8,000 years ago. See, these places, the Suleiman and the Kirthar Hills, these were the first places where crops such as wheat and barley were grown around 8,000 years ago. Now, the people living here, they also began rearing animals. They also began domesticating animals like sheep, goats, cattle, etc. So these animals, the cattle and these animals, they helped them or provided them with dairy products. The sheep provided them with wool, etc. And these people, they started living in the villages. Moving on to the Garo Hills to the northeast and the Vindhyas in the central India. See, the Garo Hills, these are situated in the northeastern states. We had studied about the seven sisters, the seven eastern states of our country. So the Garo Hills lies in the northeastern part of our country, and the Vindhyas, which lie in the central part of India. The agriculture further developed in these places. Agriculture further developed. Agriculture was made better in the Garo Hills, in the Vindhya region, etc. So the places where rice was first grown, the place where rice was first grown in India, these places are to the north of the Vindhyas. These places lie above the Vindhyas. Now moving on to River Indus and its tributaries. About 4700 years ago, some of the earliest cities flourished on the banks of these rivers, River Indus and its tributaries. Now, what do we mean by tributaries? See, tributaries are smaller rivers that flow into a larger river. Tributaries are small rivers that go and merge with larger rivers, become part of larger rivers. So the River Indus and its tributaries, around 4700 years ago, people started living along the banks of these rivers. As we can see in the map, as it is visible in the map, the River Indus and its tributaries, various cities were established at the banks of this rivers, like Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Lothal, Kalibangan, etc.